एंड वेलकम बैक. आप देख रहे हैं आज पाकिस्तान. अक्सर अगर आपको कहा जाता है कि किसी भी मुश्किल सूरत हाल से आराम से निकल आइए या अपने हौसले को बुलंद रखिए, तो कहा जाता है मे यू हैव नर्व्स ऑफ स्टील. और साथ साथ जब अपनी कामयाबी की भी बात हम करते हैं तो हम कहते हैं अपना लोहा मनवा लो. तो आज हमने सोचा कि इन्हीं दोनों चीज़ों को, ख़ास तौर पर इस इंडस्ट्री के बारे में भी बात की जाए. आपने गुज़िश्ता दौर हुकूमत में देखा कि एक बात जो हम अक्सर देख रहे थे, देयर वाज़ अ लॉट ऑफ कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्क हैपनिंग. इंटरेस्टिंगली पाकिस्तान की इकॉनमी और सोसाइटी को अगर हम देखें, जब भी देर इज़ यू नो स्टेबिलिटी, सो यू विल ऑब्वियसली सी कि यही फैक्टर हमारे यहाँ भी काम करता है, जिस तरह पूरी दुनिया में कि जैसे ही आपकी इकोनॉमिक एंड पॉलिटिकल स्टेबिलिटी आती है, हाई राइज प्रोजेक्ट्स, पीपल स्टार्ट बिल्डिंग हाउसेज, दे कैन सी कि अब उनको लॉन्ग टर्म प्लानिंग करनी है. लेकिन जब अफरा तफरी, नफसा नफसी का दौर होता है एंड बिजनेस हैज़ लेस प्रिडिक्टेबिलिटी, तो समहाउ आपकी अपना घर बनाने की जो चाह होती है वो प्रायोरिटीज़ में, तरजीहात में थोड़ी पीछे चली जाती है. राइट नाउ व्हाट इज़ द सीन? वी सी दैट देर इज़ वॉलेटिलिटी एंड अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ अनसर्टनटी इन द मार्केट. लेकिन ये इफेक्ट कैसे कर रही है? तो इट्स अ गुड बैरोमीटर. यानी अगर आपने एक चीज़, एक फैक्टर उठाना हो जो आपको थोड़ा सा ये बताए कि वॉट एग्जैक्टली इज़ हैपनिंग आउट देयर, आपको इसको इंडिकेटर के तौर पर लेना हो, तो आई थिंक स्टील्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. तो आज हमारे साथ जो हमारे मेहमान मौजूद हैं, दे आर रिप्रेजेंटिंग द अमरेली स्टील्स. मेरे साथ मौजूद हैं हादी अकबरअली, हु इज़ द चीफ ऑपरेटिंग ऑफिसर, और आप ही के साथ तशरीफ रखती हैं शहरेज़ाद समीउद्दीन, यू आर द मैनेजर CSR एंड कम्युनिकेशन. थैंक यू सो मच गाइज फॉर जॉइनिंग अस दिस मॉर्निंग.
थैंक यू फॉर
गुड मॉर्निंग टू यू. हादी, सबसे पहले नर्व्स ऑफ स्टील, बीइंग इन दिस बिजनेस, डू यू नीड टू हैव नर्व्स ऑफ स्टील?
Yes, definitely, Sidra. you mentioned the right words because everybody knows the economic situation right now. And I think any business out there right now does have to have nerves of steel to get through this period.
True.
And generally in steel, it is a cyclical industry. It's a volatile industry. And I think to ride the lows, you need nerves of steel. And when things are good and when construction is happening, then you...
So, Hadi, aap kya kahenge ki in a country of 22 crores people, aur hum dekhte hain ki jo government-run steel mills hain, they've been into a lot of news, they've been very turbulent, and you know, we've had people come out and say ki the government cannot be in the business of running the business. Kya kahenge? What does that mean for the steel industry?
I think, देखें, दुनिया में there are examples of both. There are government-run steel mills that are running very well, and they are actually global leaders. China में, India में, so it is possible.
Yes.
But अगर आप मेरा personal opinion पूछें, in Pakistan, I think it is best to probably privatize because there is so much that the government is dealing with. There is so much that our country is dealing with, and I think to be able to just privatize that, let the private sector handle it. It would be good for the industry.
What are the indicators that you're seeing? Or balki is baat se pehle Shahrezad, because the ethos of any organization is very important. Hame pata hai ki jo aapne bhi baat ki, emissions ki baat ki jaye, carbon footprint ki baat ki jaye, to people have always raised questions when it comes to the steel mills industry. Yes. Ke unki emissions bahut zyada hai, carbon footprint mein wo bahut zyada contribute kar rahe hote hain. So how are you trying to offset that? What are some of the things which are in place and some of the initiatives that you guys are taking?
Okay, so you know, there is a misperception about steel. Pakistan mein jis tarah steel banti hai, it is recycled steel.
Okay.
So we are not mining iron to create new steel. Steel hum already existing steel se bana rahe hain.
Sahi.
So it is recycled steel. So it is a highly recyclable material, and you know, that is eco-friendly in itself. But apart from that, humne apne jo plant hai, we have a plant at Dhabi ji, we are taking several initiatives over there. For instance, we recycle water. A lot of water is used during the steel production process, so we recycle that lot of water over and over, you know, it's part of the cooling process. And you know, we're doing that. We have an APC, which is an air pollution controller, which we've installed there. And I think that's quite self-explanatory कि एयर पोल्यूशन कंट्रोलर क्या होता है. वो बेसिकली जो गर्दो गुबार जो खारिज हो रहा होता है फ्रॉम द फैक्ट्री, उसको
फिल्टर करता है.
नो, एक्चुअली इट कैप्चर्स इट एंड इट सेफली डिस्पोजेस इट.
ओके.
या
आई थिंक ये मेरे ख्याल में हर भी बिजनेस के बिल्कुल सेंट्रल पॉइंट में होना चाहिए. इट इज़ अ पिवोटल पॉइंट फॉर देम टू इमेजिन कि व्हाट इज़ द इम्पैक्ट दैट दे आर हैविंग ऑन द एनवायरनमेंट एज वेल. हदी, कल भी हमने देखा कि IUCN पे वंस अगैन प्राइम मिनिस्टर इमरान खान रीइटरेटेड हिज कमिटमेंट टू क्लाइमेट. लेकिन मुझे बताएं कि टू अडॉप्ट एनी ऑफ दी सस्टेनेबल प्रैक्टिसेस, द गुड सिटीजनशिप, कॉर्पोरेट सिटीजनशिप प्रैक्टिसेस, इट कम्स विद अ कॉस्ट. और जब आप इतनी अभी वॉलेटैलिटी मार्केट में देख रहे हैं, अनसर्टनटी देख रहे हैं, हाउ आर यू कमिटेड एंड हाउ आर यू यू नो द ट्रिपल बॉटम लाइन, उसको कैसे लेके चल रहे हैं?
आपने बिल्कुल सही कहा सिद्रा, इट्स एक्चुअली इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट स्पेशली इन अ प्लेस लाइक पाकिस्तान टू बैलेंस कंप्लायंस विद कंपेटिटिवनेस, क्योंकि एंड दैट इज व्हाट ब्रिंग्स सस्टेनेबिलिटी, बट इट्स डिफिकल्ट बिकॉज रेगुलेशन इज वीक इन पाकिस्तान. इफ यू गो टू यूरोप या अगर आप अमेरिका में जाते हैं तो वहाँ एवरीबडी इज ऑन द सेम लेवल, क्योंकि सबने कंप्लाई करना होता है. There is no way that nobody can comply. But over here, when you are complying, you are actually taking on an additional cost. So there are, you have to see ways where आप अपने compliance cost को कैसे offset कर सकते हैं या कैसे उसको sustainable बना सकते हैं. So for example, जैसे 100% of our water is recycled at our plants. Now obviously that comes with the cost, क्योंकि water treatment plants, cooling towers, scale pits, सारी चीजें बना, पूरा infrastructure बनाना पड़ता
है, पूरा ecosystem बनाना पड़ता है.
Exactly, to recycle the water, but also at the same time we use less water. So us investment ka ek ROI hota hai. And I think sustainable initiatives dene ke liye you have to invest with an ROI. Otherwise agar aap cost hi lete jaye aapne aapke upar, to then you're not going to be competitive anymore and then you're really losing the whole spirit of
mujhe bataye how is the demand correlated, kyunki in the last decade we saw that the Pakistani cement industry was doing extremely well. Keh rahe the ki they're even exporting to India and the region because Afghanistan mein bahut zyada construction ho rahi thi, India mein ho rahi thi. So is our steel industry sort of you know benefiting as a subsidiary or as a supplementary or a complementary industry?
Our steel industry is very domestically centered.
Okay.
It is driven, there are exports, but it is domestically driven.
Okay.
So when Pakistan is doing well, steel is doing well, and when the economy is not good in Pakistan, steel is down.
So what is your understanding of doing business in 2020? We are indeed celebrating ki World Bank ki reports mein kaha ja raha hai ki Pakistan mein ease of doing business is better. CPEC ke upar dobara baat shuru ho chuki hai. Is that good news for the steel industry, Hadi?
I think it definitely is, but I think it's got another side of the coin as well. I think in the last 2 years, the cost of doing business has increased so much in Pakistan for all businesses across all industries.
Right.
And unfortunately, that is putting us at a disadvantage globally. And end game, aapka Pakistan mein, aap agar pure economy ko dekhe, to at the end, we need to be an exporting country. We need to become competitive globally.
Right.
And so I think the biggest challenge for us, even though there is good news of CPEC starting up and everything, the challenge, the long-term challenge is really for us to become competitive.
Achha, one of the areas which is very close to my heart, aur main usko champion bhi karti, and I really propagate it when people keep it at the center of their communications, wo hai social justice ya or social inclusion, yani wo vulnerable communities jo aapko lagta hai ki directly unke liye opportunities create nahi karti, to bring them in the center stage is something very commendable. To Shahrezad, was it a very well deliberated move ke aapki communication mein maine dekha ki when it comes to leaders you had as ambassadors or as people who you chosen as spokesperson, ek to Yunus Khan was there, and then you had Muni Mazari, who's a wheelchair bound champion of human rights. So was that well planned? Is that a part of your social inclusion initiative? How does that come together?
It is a part of our social inclusion initiative. You know, we are a very forward looking organization. We have been, you know, the community that we operate in Dhabiji. In Dhabiji, we've we have a school there, we have a women's community center there, so we are definitely working with the community that we operate in.
You have an impact, of course. So aapko kya feedback mila tha when people saw, because usually there is a lot of bravado, there is a lot of masculinity attached to the steels industry. So you had this young, petite, beautiful woman who's on a wheelchair. What kind of response did you get for it?
I think it was definitely a break from the clutter of the kind of messages that were being put out by the industry. So we definitely got noticed, and I think we also put across a very strong message about the kind of initiatives that we support and that we believe in.
So sustainability pe coming back, Hadi, what is it that you foresee agar 2020 se leke 2025, there was vision 2025 jiski bahut baat hoti thi, what will Amreli Steels be focused on? Are you looking at diversifying, expanding? What is your focus?
So I think agar hum environment sustainability ke upar baat kare between 20 and 25, as Shahrezad mentioned, there have been quite a few things that we've already done. I think going forward, we're looking at becoming carbon neutral. It's a very long-term aim, but it's I always believe that sustainability is a journey. It's not that you've thought and overnight things are happening, but that's something that we want to plan for. We're planning to go paper-free company-wide, and I think in the next 2 years, hopefully, we should be able to achieve that. We're also trying, because steel is a very energy-intensive process, so कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि हम रिन्यूएबल्स भी अपने मिक्स के अंदर ले आएँ. तो वी इन्वेस्टिंग इन सोलर पावर टू ऑफसेट आर कार्बन फुटप्रिंट. वी आर ऑल्सो डूइंग प्लांटेशन ड्राइव्स इन धाबेजी अराउंड आवर कम्युनिटी.
सो Hadi, डू यू इंटरैक्ट विद यंग अपकमिंग बिजनेस प्रोफेशनल्स एंड ग्रेजुएट्स? बिकॉज आई एम थिंकिंग दिस बिकॉज आई सी अल्हम्दुलिल्लाह यू हैव अ ग्रेट बैकग्राउंड. आई सी यू एज अ यंग इंस्पायरिंग कॉर्पोरेट लीडर इन पाकिस्तान. यू हैव योर MBA फ्रॉम INSEAD. यहाँ पे जो बिजनेस स्टूडेंट्स हैं अभी हु गोइंग टू पाकिस्तानी बिजनेस स्कूल्स, वट वुड बी योर एडवाइस? बिकॉज वी नीड अ वेरी एजाइल, अ वेरी फ्लेक्सिबल, अ वेरी फॉरवर्ड लुकिंग स्किल सेट फ्रॉम देम. सो अगर मैं आपसे एज एन ऑर्गनाइजेशन एंड ऑल्सो एज अ कॉर्पोरेट लीडर कहूँ, वट वुड बी योर एडवाइस टू दैम?
You know, I think my advice to young people graduating from business schools over here would be that I think Pakistan has a lot of opportunity, and I think it's a place where as a young person you can take a risk at a young age and start your own business, start something new. There are so many ideas going around. We had the O21 Disrupt recently, yes. And yes. It was, I mean, the kind of people, the kind of community that was built over there was just amazing.
The energy over there was absolutely mind-blowing, yeah. Because you had people come in who believed in their ideas. Never before did you have this kind of power ke aap ek idea soche, aapko like-minded log mil jaye, and you become this, you know, yeah. The time of those ideas, yeah. Has come. To mujhe ye bataein ke the people who are feeling, main particular aakhri sawal aapse ye karna chahungi, nerves of steel se humne ye baat shuru ki thi. Uncertainty mein jo log business manage kar रहे हैं उनका तो टेस्ट है ही Hadi, लेकिन साथ साथ वो लोग जिन्होंने फॉर एग्जांपल दिस साइक्लिकल डाउनटर्न दैट वी आर गोइंग थ्रू उसकी वजह से अपनी जॉब्स खो दी हैं. देयर इज अ यू नो ट्रेमेंडस अमाउंट ऑफ राइट साइजिंग डाउनसाइजिंग हैपनिंग. जो लोग इस वक्त बिटवीन जॉब्स हैं उनको आपका क्या मशवरा होगा?
सो आई विल गो बैक टू जो आपने बात की थी अबाउट अ कैंपेन एंड विद मुनीबा मजारी. एक्चुअली द क्रक्स ऑफ दैट वाज रेजिलियंस,
यस,
एंड दैट इज सम एंड द रीजन वी चोज दैट टू डिपिक्ट दैट थ्रू सच अ ब्यूटीफुल एंड सच अ
इंस्पायरिंग
यंग पर्सन वाज दैट बिकॉज इट रिलेट्स टू ऑल ऑफ अस, वेदर इट्स पीपल हु आर बिटवीन देयर जॉब्स,
yes,
whether it's businesses who are struggling and trying to ride this economic downturn,
yeah.
Or whether it's even steel itself,
as human beings, yeah. And maybe your business is doing great, but there are other things which are, you know, Bilkul. Probably coming to you or getting
and
to you.
And for young people who are starting out in business right now, I think it's a very important thing that, you know, you need to be there for the long term. True. You need to have the grit, the perseverance to ride through, and results will come. You just have to be at it.
Thank you so much, Hadi and Shahrezad, for being here this morning, staying true to their message of having nerves of steel, persevering, and of course being resilient is the key message over here. Aur isi ke sath hum padte hain ek chote se break ki taraf, lekin wapas aayenge. Aur humne kaha tha ki aaj ka big discussion is going to be about government jobs, ki kyun hame lagta hai ki wahan pe merit ki qadar nahi ki jati. We'll be back, ek chota sa break lete hain.